All right, in today's video, we're going to go over how to connect the Yamaha engine to non-standard gauges, i.e. gauges that are not Yamaha. In this case, we're using Teleflex gauges, but this would apply whether they're Teleflex or Faria gauges. In any event, let me go ahead and get started. Before I do that, go ahead and hit the subscribe button, hit the bell button, you'll get notifications in the future when I put videos up. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is tackle the tilt trim sending unit. There is a pink wire in these bundles, and you can see it here, actually. This is the sending unit, or goes to the sending unit for tilt and trim. There's not a lot of wire to work with here, and I don't have the plug for this, unfortunately. So what we're going to do is tackle the wire itself. Unfortunately, I don't have a connector for that, so I'm going to cut into the wire. I really hate to do this. Let's get this out of the way. I do have a wire I ran to the front, to the console of the engine here, so whole idea is to tie it into this and then check and see if it works. I'm literally going to skin this. I could just cut the wire, but I'd rather not, although I'm getting ready to go there. I want to preserve the original connection, if it's possible. Before I go any further, try something. I may just solder this. Here's a quick test of the tilt and trim. So as far as the tilt trim meter, I've already installed that in the console. It's really simple. You've got your positive, your negative, and your signal. And the signal is what's coming from the back of the engine. And that's just basically resistance. If we look over here, you'll see that Yamaha from 2001 and up, outboards, the range is from 10 ohms to 167 ohms. Older than that is 110 ohms to 410 ohms, so you might have a little bit of difficulty with a modern gauge doing an older outboard, but works just fine with this one. All right, so I've tested it. It tests fine. I'm going to tie in to this. Actually, I've put the plugs back in. One of the things I found out, you only plug this in together when you're using the Yamaha gauges and system. I forget exactly what it's called, but we're not doing that. So what I'm going to do is use a fine gauge wire. I think this is 18 gauge. not the best in the world, but these were originally tied together with
like a zip tie or something.
No, this yellow tape.
You want to try and do that again?
Yeah, you're only supposed to connect those two. They have plugs in them.
Yeah, for the Yamaha ones?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's sticky on both sides.
Flux.
Tuck that back in there. And then I'm going to terminate these two together. Actually, this is funny because the terminals I'm using are so big that what I need to do is double this up.
I know that, but you said you need to double it up.
Oh, no, what I'm going to do is tin it. They're both hot. Them cool off a minute.
Go and test it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no.
Do a quick test. I'll put the camera on the gauge later when we're all done with everything.
Oh yeah. Working?
Yep.
Okay. Very nice.
All right, now to hook up the tachometer. And we picked that off of the controller. In this case, it's a 704 controller. Doesn't matter if it's a binnacle or a side mount. Likewise, it'll also be the same for a 703 controller because I've done those before. And what we need to do to access it is take this key thing off. So I'm going to show you the exact wire that you need to tap into with a bullet connector. Here you go. It is this green wire, and that has a female bullet connector. What we're going to do is connect this green wire to the input to the tachometer. I've already got the tachometer adjusted, so I'm going to take these panels off. So what we're going to do, we're going to run this down through the guides. Showed everybody my underwear, and I'm probably wearing red underwear, which usually makes it very.
You might need to go underneath. Yeah, I'll pass it under.
I think there's another guy in there, but I'm not even going to try to.
I can't see it.
No, that's fine. All right, so we've got it out here. Next step's gonna be, let's strip it, add a bullet connector to it. And can you get me the heat gun? I got, yeah. Wait. Oh no, I gotta get the crimper too.
I'll get that.
You reinstall these, check the connectors in the back because some of them came loose, so I pushed them back on.
All right, we'll let that cool off before cut that to length, get a ring connector on there. Goes to zero. Oops. The horn works. Not that we wanted to test it, but all right, let's fire it up. And it's showing about 9,000 RPM. I think once it warms up, it should drop to about 8. Shut it down. All right, you've seen how we got this done. The gauges are working correctly. I'm pleased with it. It's not that hard. And just to go over it real quick, it's the pink wire at the engine, and you'll see two connectors that come taped together. Don't connect those together. You can, they have plugs in them. They are there for the Yamaha system. I forget exactly off the top of my head what it's called. But you pick off the pink wire. However you do that, it's up to you. I chose to solder it. And you know, that was my choice. The tachometer is going to be the green wire coming off of your controller, and it's the same for a 704, 703 side mount, binnacle mount controller. So you can always pick off your tach there. You just have to be sure that you select the correct number of poles on the tachometer. That's it, and you should be good to go. Anyway, I hope this video has been helpful to you. If it has, hit share and like, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.